split decision, so obviously not an easy fight. Very back and forth. I think he got the better of you on the striking. He's a little taller, a little bit longer reach, but your wrestling pulled it out for you. Yeah. You had some pretty good slams. That one slam where you dumped him was real good, right inside control. What was your plan going to this fight? Did you know anything about him? Did you always want to wrestle? Is that
what you... Oh, yeah. I mean, I've wrestled since I was age of six, so I've always wanted to get into something more higher level. In this fight, I knew he was probably going to be a pretty good striker from when I found out about him, but I knew that my wrestling was definitely top notch and definitely planned on using that as soon as I got in.
So what's next for you? You got another fight coming up, or are you going to go back to the drawing board a little bit?
I mean, definitely got to go back to the drawing board. Always going to improve, always to get better. Definitely want to improve my striking a little more, but I definitely want to get back into the ring and do what I do best.
What gym do you train out of?
It's not necessarily like a gym. It's more of a private trainer kind of deal. My trainer kind of comes with me to different places like Red Rocks or anywhere that I can go.
So you're an independent fighter?
Yes.
Any sponsors?
No, not yet, but I always hope to get one.
I'm looking for one. What's your record?
Right now it's 1-0.
1-0, so that was your first fight?
Yes, sir.
Now you're undefeated?
Yes, sir.
All right, so potential sponsors, can find you on Facebook?
Yes, definitely.
Brandon Donnelly?
Brandon Donnelly, yeah.
Okay. Anything else you'd like to get out there?
I'd like to say, thank you to Dave Sinnott. He definitely got me to where I am now. Nick Jacerda, Matt Castellanos, and all my friends and family. Everyone's supported me throughout the entire way and helped me get better and helped me become a better fighter.
Well,